हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर अशोक कुमार फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट वुमेन इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज अजमेर। दिस इज लेक्चर 4 ऑन मोबाइल कम्युनिकेशन एंटीना सीरीज एंड इन दिस लेक्चर 4 वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट स्लॉट एंटीना। द फॉलोइंग कंटेंट्स विल बी एड्रेस्ड ड्यूरिंग दिस लेक्चर 4 ऑफ दिस सीरीज। इनिशियली द डिजाइन एंड एनालिसिस ऑफ स्लॉट एंटीना, देन वन प्रॉब्लम बेस्ड ऑन स्लॉट एंटीना डिजाइन। The contents of this lecture is prepared with the help of this reference book. First, we are going to discuss about slot antenna, and first we need to understand what is slot antenna. So we can say that a slot antenna is a radiating element which typically is formed by cutting an opening on a ground plane. Here you can see this is a substrate, and that substrate is having the dielectric constant epsilon r and height h of the substrate that we have considered. And in this substrate we are taking one ground plane, and this ground plane suppose having some length. Suppose this is lg is the length of ground plane and this is w of g is the width of ground plane. In that case we are cutting a slot. As you can see, this slot we have cut from the ground plane, and this opening we have called as a slot instead of aperture, and the length L should be greater than the width of the ground plane or this radiating element, as you can see. And this radiating element is fed at the center. Here you can see this is a voltage source that we have considered. For the proper radiation of this slot antenna, the length of the slot, as you can see, this is the length of the slot, and length of the slot L should be equal to half of the wavelength or nearly equal to half of the wavelength, as you can see in expression 11. So we have considered the length of the slot is equal to L equal to lambda by 2, where lambda is equal to V naught upon root of epsilon r, which depends on the speed of the light and the dielectric constant, or we can say relative permittivity of the substrate, and the width W. And this width W is small as compared to length L. In that case, W is considered in this range 0.05 minus 0.1 whole multiply lambda, less than or equal to. So we can say W is always we have considered about 0.05 lambda or 0.06 lambda, 0.07 lambda. In this way we, or in this manner we have considered. So we can say the length of the slot L is nearly equal to lambda by 2, and width as you can see in expression 12. So this is the basic configuration of the slot antenna, and this slot antenna is excited with the voltage excitation. Here you can see, and the slot is usually excited by the voltage source placed symmetrically in the middle of the slot at lambda by 4 from the each of its edges. Here you can see this is we can term as edge 1, and this is term as edge 2. So we have feed this antenna, slot antenna, from the edge 1 to from the edge 1 to lambda by 4 distance, or edge 2 from the lambda by 4 distance. So we can say at the mid we are providing the voltage source excitation in a slot antenna. For such symmetrical excitation, the voltage reaches at its maximum at the center. Here you can see this is the voltage variation or voltage distribution, and this we have termed as a 0 volt, and this is as termed as a maximum voltage. And along the width you can see we have termed as a voltage across the slot or aperture, and this is the length. So here you can see at the center the voltage is maximum, and you can see from this slot 1 from the lambda by 4 distance, or slot 2 from the lambda by 4 distance, and this voltage it reaches minimum at the edges. As you can see, this is edge 1 and this is edge 2. So we can say this is the voltage distribution on a slot antenna. In contrast, the current, as you can see, current is negative at one edge. As you can see, this is termed as edge 1. In that case, it is having a negative current at one edge and this is positive at the other edge. And here you can see one important at the mid of this slot. Here you can getting the value of current is minimum. I mean current is zero, and this current zero is termed as a open circuit element in the case of slot antenna. Or we can also say the polarity of this current distribution may be changed. Suppose if from the slot from the edge of one of the slot, that it may be the positive and this may be the negative, but in both cases at the center the current is zero. So this is the voltage and current distribution that we have observed in a slot antenna when we are taking the length of the slot L equal to lambda by 2 and W is small as compared to length L. So we can say that slot is the complement of a dipole type of radiator, where the arms of the dipoles, you can see we have considered as a perfect electric conducting strips for a L equal to lambda by 2 length slot and the dipole, where the slot excitation at the center is replaced by that of the dipole. Here you can see this is the half wavelength thin slot on a electrical screen, perfect electric conductor screen, and this is a complement structure. So here you can see the current is minimum at the center where we are providing the feed, but voltage is maximum as we have discussed. But in the case of lambda by 2 flat thin dipole, in that case the current is maximum at the center and minimum at the edges of this lambda by 2 dipole, but the voltage is minimum at the center where we are providing the feed, but maximum at the edges. So this is the analysis of slot antenna and the dipole antenna. In that case we can say this slot antenna and this dipole antenna are the complementary structures. So during this complementary structure, the impedance of the dipole is termed as a Zd in a free space, and that is related to the slot in a free space Zs by the Babinet principle. And the Babinet principle we have discussed in a separate lecture. And it is equal to Zd into Zs. I mean in impedance of a dipole into impedance of a slot equal to neta naught square by 4, where neta naught is the free space intrinsic impedance. So we can say that the slot antenna is a bidirectional radiator, and that radiate in both forward as well as backward direction of the ground plane. So we can say this antenna, slot antenna, may radiate in the form of bidirectional radiator or figure of 8 shapes like this. This is the plus Z direction suppose, and this is the minus Z direction. In that case it is radiating bidirectional, but it is also radiating the omnidirection across the periphery of this slot antenna when we are considering as a planar structure. Typically, to convert the radiation pattern unidirectional from the bidirectional, in that case we are considering a cavity that is inserted in its back side, reducing it to what is usually referred to as a cavity backed slot antenna, and CBS antenna we are saying. So we can say that the directional that the radiation properties of the slot antenna can be make unidirectional by adding the CBS antenna on the back side or reflecting surface on the back side of the antenna. So this is the phenomena that is being used to consider to make the antenna directional or unidirectional. And this is the configuration that we have discussed. So we can see that slot antenna is generally based on the Babinet principle, and it is we can say that slot antenna is a complementary structure of the dipole antenna when it is fed at the center from the one edge to lambda by 4 distance that we have discussed in this lecture. And one problem we are considered to understand the design procedure of a slot antenna. In that problem, some parameters are given, that W is given and length L is given, and we need to calculate the value of Z of S. So the slot L and W is a complementary structure of a thin strip half wavelength dipole A equal to lambda by 2 dipole whose ideal thin wire input impedance ZD 73 plus J42.5, and this input impedance that we have discussed in the wire antenna series during the analysis of a half wavelength dipole antenna, and this value we have considered from that place. So by using equation 13, as we can see, this is a equation 13 that we are getting from the Babinet principle. So by using this equation 13, we can calculate the value of input impedance of the slot ZS, which is equal to eta naught upon 4 ZD, and we have calculated this value. Similarly, when this same problem, when we are analyzing on the commercial CEM software, computational electromagnetic software, this type of software may be the CST microwave studio, HFSS simulator, or some other kind of simulator that is being used. The simulated input impedance of a slot ZS with L and W on a 5 lambda into 5 lambda PEC ground plane. So this is the length, as we have discussed, this is the length of the ground plane LG, and this is the width of the W ground plane, that is W of G, that we have considered. In that case, we can after simulating this design structure on some particular CEM software, in this case we are getting ZS is equal to 339.38 minus J78.85, while the input impedance of 339.3 ohm is closer to the analytical value of 362.95 ohm. The simulated reactance, I mean capacitive, of minus 70 ohm is considerably different from the analytical value of minus 211.31. So you can compare the calculated value and the commercial CEM value, then you are getting one important conclusion, that is the width of the slot decreases. In that case, the simulated capacitive reactance becomes more negative and approaches the analytical one. So we can say that this width can be reduced. In that case, we can increase the capacitance and we can match the input impedance of the slot antenna. Thank you everyone for watching this lecture. I hope this lecture is beneficial for you. In the next lecture of this series, I mean subsequent lecture, we are going to discuss about some other kind of antenna that is being used in a mobile communication system. Thank you.